Mute. I
can you hear now? Yeah. Can you hear me now? Okay. So they are basically known as benzos. Quinoline is basically known as benzo B pyridine, and isoquinoline is known as benzo C quinoline. They are present in crude oil basically. Okay. Please come online as early as possible. Don't keep on coming in between. This is a headache for me. Okay. Application. Quinoline is used in the manufacturing of dyes, preparations of hydroxyquinoline, sulfate, niacin. They are also used as a solvent for resins and terpenes. It's a precursor for 8-hydroxyquinoline, which is used as a chelating agent, and is also present in pesticide. 2 and 4 methyl derivatives are used for precursor of cyanine dyes. Oxidation gives quinolinic or pyridine dicarboxylic acid, which is a precursor for many compounds. Okay. So quinoline and isoquinoline, they are nothing but two fused hydroxide derived from fusion of pyridine and your benzene. They are formed by the fusion of pyridine and benzene. Quinoline has got high boiling point of 237 degrees Celsius and smells like pyridine, while isoquinoline has a low melting it's a low melting point solid of melting point 26.5 and boiling point of 243. Okay. Both quinoline and isoquinoline are planar. It contains 10 pi electrons. So it satisfies your Huckel's rule. All of the atoms are sp2 hybridized and contribute one electron each in your p orbital for your delocalization across the ring, and it has got resonance energy of 198 and 143. So it has got, respectively, this quinoline has got a resonance energy of 198 and isoquinoline has got a resonance energy of 143. Just because of all these characters, quinoline is said to be aromatic in nature. Okay, this is the reason why quinoline. So they have got 10 pi electrons. So how can you say 8 plus 2? So this Huckel's rule is satisfied. If you see the structure of quinoline, it contains 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 pi electrons. It contains 10 pi electrons. Thus, the Huckel rule is satisfied. The entire ring is planar. Each and every atom is sp2 hybridized, and all the p orbitals involved in this bond formation are in conjugation, and they are involved in your delocalization of your electrons. They are coplanar, and thus, since they satisfy all the criteria for aromatic compound, that's why quinoline and isoquinoline are aromatic in nature. Now the resonance structure. Of your quinoline. What do you see? The first. These are the two forms of your quinoline. If you can see, these are the different structures of your quinoline that can be present. So I want you to draw this structure. See, if you can see first ring, if you can see the, so there is a, so this is the first structure. Yeah, this is the first structure. Yeah, See the second structure. Now this bond comes over here, this bond comes over here, and this bond comes over here. So 1, 2, 3. So your pyridine ring is not changed, only your benzene ring is changed. In the third structure, what happened? This comes over here, this goes over here, this goes over here. Okay, this is the structure. So what is the third structure? This is the third structure. Similarly, again, what is the next thing that happens once this comes out? Okay, now this ring, this comes over here. Okay, when this comes over here, so next ring is, when you see there is a shift of electron that over here, this next is when this comes over here, the negative charge comes over here and the positive charge comes over here, and so on. You can be continuously writing different structures of your resonance. So there are n structures, number of structures for the quinoline, where the positive charge will come at each and every position of your carbon. So the positive charge will come at each and every position of your carbon, and the nitrogen will be carrying the negative charge. If you see the structure, the negative charge will be on the nitrogen and the positive charge will be on the carbon atom. So if there is a positive charge on the carbon atom, so it is a deactivating group. So your electrophilic substitution reaction will be hard to happen. Okay, it will be hard to happen. Now the synthesis. First synthesis is crop synthesis. This comes for 5 marks. This comes for 5 marks. This comes for 5 marks. Okay, very important. Just mark an important to this. So what is the condition over here? What is crop synthesis? When aniline is treated with glycerol in presence of concentrated H2SO4 and nitrobenzene, and you heat it at high temperature, it forms your quinoline. Please write this one. So what is this thing? So when aniline is treated with glycerol, when aniline is treated with glycerol in presence of H2SO4 and nitrobenzene, and in this case nitrobenzene acts as an oxidizing agent. So this is the overall reaction. What is the reaction? When aniline is treated with glycerol in presence of nitric acid, it forms, and nitrobenzene in presence of concentrated H2SO4 and nitrobenzene, it forms your quinoline. So this is a stepwise method. So what is the first step? If you see what is the first step? First step is nothing but your glycerol. It undergoes dehydration, loss of water due to H2SO4. So in acidic medium, it undergoes dehydration to form your, so this water molecule is lost, it forms your crotonic aldehyde. There is loss of two molecules of water. And it forms acrolein. And this acrolein, which is formed, that condenses with your aniline to give you this particular intermediate. It undergoes nucleophilic attack. This is followed by your cyclization in presence of nitrobenzene to form your quinoline. So this is your basic stepwise mechanism. So this is what is your introduction. Please write this much. Please write this much. So there is one more step over here, minus plus two. And the final step is cyclization using nitrobenzene. So these are the steps. These are the three basic steps involved. Now, how this exact mechanism occurs has to be explained for 5 marks. If it comes for 2 marks, this much is enough. If it comes for 2 marks, this much is enough. Now, if you come for 5 marks, you have to explain the mechanism of action. You have to explain the mechanism of action. If you have written this much, I'll go for the mechanism. If you have written this slide, please say yes, I'll go for the next slide. This is very important. This comes for 5 marks. This comes for 5 marks. Keep it in your mind. This question comes for 5 marks. Crop synthesis comes for 5 marks in your exam. Okay? Comes for 5 marks in your exam. So can we go for the next slide? Yes, okay. So people are coming in between again and again. I don't know. So first step of your crop synthesis. Now listen carefully when I'm explaining. Listen very carefully. It is very important thing. This comes, when it comes for 5 marks, you have to write this steps. Okay? It is very much important. Now see the first step. First step is formation of your acrolein. Formation of your acrolein. If you see the structure, OH, H, OH. So what is the first step? What is the first step? What is the first step? First off is protonation of your central OH and loss of, the first step is protonation of your central OH. Then there is loss of water. There is loss of water. So there is, so this comes here. This goes off. So formation of a double bond and there is a loss of water. This is OH, double bond. This is the first step. So again, next step is your terminal, this one gets protonated. Your terminal hydroxyl group gets protonated. OH. Yes. Again, so there is a loss of water. So when there is a loss of water, this comes over here. Okay, there is a loss of water. There is an, so when this comes over, so this comes over here, this goes over here, and water is lost. So the proton from here forms a double bond. This double bond gets shifted. There is a shift to 1,4 shift. Okay, there is an 1,4 shift. There is a shift in the double bond, and you get your corresponding acrolein. You get your corresponding acrolein. So you get your acrolein. Did you understand the first step? Everybody, did you understand the first step? Please write it according to this. The first is your protonation of your central OH. Okay. Then loss of water to form a double bond. Again, the protonation of your terminal OH. Then there is a loss of water molecule. And there is a shift of the double bond. The H gets transferred over here to form a carbonyl group, and this double bond gets shifted over here, and there is a loss of water. The water is lost to form the acrolein. So did you get the first step? Formation of acrolein, did you understand? Can you go for the next slide? Have you written this slide? Okay, I'll go for the next slide. So I'll go for the okay. So we'll go the first step is the formation of acrolein is over. Okay, now we'll go for the next slide. So what is the next step? Addition action of acrolein on anilin, forming an addition product. So what is the next step? Your nitrogen in your amino group in your aniline. So ammonia group in your amino group in your aniline attacks on your acrolein. So see the step, if you look at the board. Okay, so this lone pair will attack on your this goes up and this forms an OH in your acidic medium. So in presence of acidic medium, so what happens? See this NH2, there is a shift of double bond and you get an OH. Okay, understood this step? Yes. So there is an addition product. So this nitrogen attacks on your double bond. There is shift of double bond. It forms an OH in your acidic medium. And to form an acidic, in acidic medium, it forms an OH in all. So this is an in all form. Okay. Now what happens next step? There is a loss of proton. Proton. So what you get? NH. Double bond O. Did you get this step? The proton, extra proton in your amino group. In your amino group is removed and you get your particular intermediate. Okay. This is your enol intermediate. Now this enol, it undergoes ketoenol tautomerism. When it undergoes ketoenol tautomerism, this double bond gets converted to a single bond and this OH gets converted to your carbonyl group. Did you get this step? Everybody, did you get this step? It undergoes tautomerism. So your OH gets converted to your carbonyl group and your double bond is removed. Okay, so you get your, there is a ketoenol tautomerism. Did you understand till here? So once this this thing is formed, once this step is formed, so in your acidic medium this gets protonated. So in acidic medium this gets protonated. your oxygen in your carbonyl group gets protonated, and this will lead to your intramolecular. Intramolecular rearrangement. What does it happen? It undergoes intramolecular rearrangement. So what happens? This bond comes over here. This goes up. And lone pair of electrons on hydrogen will come over here. So what you get is next intermediate is and an H and a positive charge over here and a positive charge over here. So this is an intramolecular rearrangement takes place. This is followed by a loss of proton. Once there is an intramolecular rearrangement, again there is a loss of proton, and this proton comes here to attain your aromatics. In doing so, this comes back. Okay, till here, did you understand this step, everybody? Just a minute, I will write it again. So you have seen over here. Just look it over properly. OH. Positive charge. So what happens in the next step? There is a loss of proton to attain aromaticity, and this comes up, and you get this particular intermediate. There is an interconversion. So what do you get? 3-NH-OH. Okay, next step is what? Now again in the acidic medium, what happens? This OH gets protonated and there is a loss of water. There is minus H2O. There is a loss of water and you get your NH double bond. So this is your first intermediate, and this undergoes oxidation in presence of nitro benzene to give you your quinoline. So I want you to come online and ask this before I go for the next preparation, because this is very much important. Can anybody come online? Ashika, can you come online? Abdul Migdad, please. So Ashika, can you come online?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ashika, did you understand this? So I'll be explaining you along with the each and every step. And if you have not understood any step, please ask me. Okay. So I'll be explaining from the first step. Everybody listen now. I'll be talking to Ashika. Okay, Ashika, what is the first step? Protonation of your central middle oxygen. Yeah. Then what happens? There is a loss of water. Okay. Water is lost. Again, next step is what? Protonation of your terminal OH. And then next step is loss of water. There is a shift of your proton in a terminal to form a particular acrolein, and there is a shift of your double bond to form your acrolein. So this acrolein is formed. This is the first step of your Scrop synthesis. Now, what is the next step once this is formed? Now, this acrolein attacks on your aniline, which you have added in the reaction. That aniline acts on your acrolein. Okay, double bond acrolein, and there is a shift of double bond. So in acidic medium, it forms an enol. You can see it over here. It forms an enol. So then this attacks over here, the double bond gets shifted, and this carbonyl group gets converted to your OH in presence of your acidic medium. So this is the first step of your acrolein reaction with your aniline. So once this next step is your loss of your proton. So your proton is lost, and you get your third intermediate. Got this intermediate, everybody? Yeah, how this intermediate is formed? So now this enol intermediate that is formed undergoes tautomerism. Undergoes what?
Tautomerism.
Ketoenol tautomerism. So that OH gets converted to your ketone, and your double bond is now converted to a saturated form. Okay? So this is the ketoenol tautomerism. After that ketoenol tautomerism, the carbonyl group gets protonated in your acidic medium. So once it gets protonated, there is an intramolecular addition reaction. So one of the double bond in the ring attacks your OH, and the lone pair of the nitrogen, lone pair of the electrons in the nitrogen gets attached to the ring. Okay, can you see this over here? See, this lone pair of the electrons in the nitrogen comes over here, and the double bond in the ring attacks over here to your carbonyl group, and the double bond gets transferred to your O. So that's why there is an intramolecular transition. There is an intramolecular reaction. So people are coming online. I don't know what is happening today. Okay. So there is an intramolecular addition. Did you understand this step, Ashika? This is the important step to be understood. So what happens? The lone pair of electrons shifts to your benzene ring, and the double bond from your benzene ring attacks on your carbonyl. And the double bond in the carbonyl gets shifted to your O. So this is the intramolecular rearrangement. Next step is you can see that hydrogen, which is present in the ring, it gets shifted to the ring to attain aromaticity, and again the lone double bond between your nitrogen and ring comes back to the nitrogen to form the particular intermediate. Now the next step is your protonation of your OH. Protonation of your OH. This is followed by dehydration. And you get your particular, you see, the double bond is at the third and the fourth position. And next step is oxidation using nitrobenzene, and you get your quinoline. I'm telling you, this is a sure shot question in your exam. 9 out of 10 times examiner ask this question for 5 marks. 9 out of 10 times the examiners will ask you this question in your final exam. It's a common question which is asked for 5 marks. Okay, so put a triple asterisk for this question. Okay, Scrop synthesis. Everybody, did you understand, Ashika, this reaction? Very important.
Yes, sir.
All the steps?
And
now you explain me the entire steps. I listen to you. Now I'll not talk. You have to tell.
First step.
Yeah, tell me.
First, in the glycerol will central hydroxyl group of glycerol will be protonated.
Yeah.
Then dehydration, loss of water molecule.
Yes.
Formation of double bond takes place.
Yeah.
Again, the protonation of the terminal hydroxyl group.
Yeah.
Water molecule will be eliminated. Shifting of this double bond.
Yeah.
Formation of acrolein takes place.
Okay. Next.
Next. Aniline, what we have added, will... its lone pair will attack the double bond in the acrolein. It gets shifted, and the upper double bond goes to oxygen. And here enol formation takes place.
Okay.
Next, a proton present in the aniline will move to the nitrogen.
Proton, no, lone pair.
Lone pair present.
So there is an intramolecular intramolecular rearrangement that takes place. Electrophilic addition takes place. Intramolecular addition, electrophilic addition takes place. Okay. Tell. Tell Ashika. Talk.
Ketoenol transition takes tautomerism occurs. Formation of ketone group takes place. Later it gets protonated.
Yeah, good.
Then there will be intramolecular transition.
Yeah. When the lone pair from the nitrogen comes to the ring and the benzene ring attack on your benzene ring. The double bond from the ring attacks on your carbonyl carbon and it forms your OH. Okay. OH. Then now what is the next step? There is
next
loss
hydrogen
of
hydrogen in the benzene.
Yeah, hydrogen in the ring benzene is lost and it forms a aromatic ring. Okay, can you see it forms an aromatic ring? And again, the lone double bond gets shifted to your nitrogen to form the lone pair.
Nitrogen.
Okay, then what is the next step? Your OH gets protonated.
Protonated again. Okay. Later, there will be loss of water molecule.
Okay, to give you a particular intermediate. Okay.
Yeah.
And that undergoes oxidation in presence of nitrobenzene. In presence of your nitrobenzene to give your quinoline. So you have understood this. This is important from your examination point of view. Okay. Put a triple asterisk for this question. Okay. For this part of your topic. Okay. I'll go for the next slide then. So next is Friedlander's synthesis. Next is your Friedlander's synthesis. Where? Ortho-amino-benzaldehyde. Where? Ortho-amino-benzaldehyde. Where? Ortho-amino-benzaldehyde is treated with acetaldehyde. So it is a condensation reaction. It is a condensation reaction. Ortho-amino benzaldehyde. So this is a benzaldehyde. It's an amino group at an ortho. So it will react with what? Acid. This is CH2. Acetaldehyde. So what happens? This comes and this undergoes condensation to give you your quinoline. Okay. To give you our quinoline. There is a condensation. So what is shown in the red? They undergo condensation reaction. Okay? They undergo condensation reaction and you get your corresponding quinoline. What is Friedlander's synthesis? You treat ortho-amino benzaldehyde with acetaldehyde. It undergo in presence of a base. It undergoes condensation reaction to give you a corresponding quinoline. Write it down, okay, simultaneously. Next is Debner-Miller synthesis. So next is Debner-Miller synthesis. What happens in this stage? There is a self-condensation between your two molecules of acetaldehyde to give you your acrolein, to give you your methyl acrolein. So what do you get? You get him. So what happens? This undergoes, in presence of a base, it undergoes self-condensation to give methyl acrolein. So it undergoes self-condensation reaction to give your methyl. This is an example of aldol condensation. Now it happens similar to that of your Scrop synthesis. It attacks over here and you get an methylated quinoline. Only difference between Debner-Miller and this thing is that instead of your, so what you take as a starting material over here in case of Scrop synthesis, glycerol. You are taking an acetaldehyde. So these two acetaldehyde will give you a methylated acrolein. There you get a simple acrolein. Here you get a methylated acrolein. And this also undergoes the same one for addition in case with aniline, there is a intramolecular leading to a formation of your 2-methyl-1,2-dihydroquinoline, and this undergoes oxidation to give you your 2-methylquinoline. So please write this thing also. It is similar to that of your Scrops synthesis. It is similar to that of your Scrops. Only difference is that you get a 2-methylquinoline moiety, whereas in case of Scrop you get a quinoline moiety, plain quinoline, and here you get a 2-methylquinoline. So can I go for the next slide? Did you understand this? Say yes or no. Did you understand this synthesis, Dubner-Miller synthesis? Can somebody come online and say? Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you. I'll go for the next slide. Okay. So we'll go for the next. Now, here, this was the synthesis of quinoline. Now we'll go for the synthesis of isoquinoline. Synthesis of isoquinoline. 2 years back, this Neyer-Replisky synthesis had come for 5 marks. 2 years back, in your final exam, this question, Beyers-Replisky had come for 5 marks. So Beyers-Replisky had come for 5 marks 2 years back. So what it is? So it is nothing but you take what? You take beta phenyl ethylamine. So this is CH2, CH2, NS2. This is alpha, beta, and beta position you cut a phenyl ring. So this take a beta phenylamine, you treat it with, it undergoes acetylation. Okay, it undergoes acetylation. You treat it with any substituted acetyl group or methyl or something. So you treat it with acetyl chloride. So you get an acetyl derivative of this thing. CH2 and H C double bond O R. So this is what you get. So this, when you treat it with phosphoric acid, so when it is phosphorus pentoxide, it undergoes dehydration. That is, it undergoes dehydration and cyclization. It undergoes dehydration and cyclization. It undergoes dehydration and cyclization. You get a R-N. So that is an R substituted isoquinoline. You get an R substituted 3,4 dihydro isoquinoline. So R substituted 3,4 dihydro isoquinoline. This on oxidation with palladium carbon. This on oxidation with, in presence of palladium carbon, gets converted into your R substituted isoquinoline. You get an R substituted isoquinoline. So did you understand this reaction? What is the first step? First step is your acylation reaction. Where you treat beta phenyl ethylamine with your acyl chloride. So you form, get an acylated derivative. This, when you treat it with phosphorus pentoxide, it undergoes cyclization and you get an R substituted 3,4 dihydro isoquinoline. And this R substituted 3,4 dihydro isoquinoline, when it is treated with palladium carbon, it undergoes oxidation by removal of your 2 hydrogen to give your substituted 1 R substituted isoquinoline. Okay, got this? Please write this. I'll give you 2 minutes to write this entire thing, entire synthesis. Please write this. So I'll go for the next. So next is Pomeran fruit synthesis. Next is Pomeran fruit synthesis, where you treat and benzaldehyde with diethoxy amino ethyl group. So it will undergo condensation, the same reaction. So this is the two ethyl groups, that is an acetal form. They are unstable in acidic medium. They undergo cyclization to give your corresponding isoquinoline. Please write this reaction. So what happens? If you see over here, this aldehyde attacks on your amine, okay? And this two ethyl group, they are very unstable in your acidic medium. So it will give your corresponding ketone groups. So these two groups are only attached to protect your carbonyl group. So that there are no two carbonyl groups present in the ring. So the carbonyl gets converted into an acetyl group. So this attacks over here, and in acidic medium only they break later on to give your corresponding cyclized your isoquinoline. So please write this reaction. You just come in a minute. Can you go for the next slide? Now the reactions of quinoline. Now why quinoline is basic in nature? It's less basic than weaker. It's a weaker base than quinoline, than pyridine, because it reacts with your acid to form a quinolinium hydrochloride salt, and which is sparingly soluble in water. Okay, that's why it is basic in nature. So quinoline is basic in nature. Now the reactions. So like pyridine, quinoline also undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction at C2 and C4. So as you have seen in pyridine, pyridine undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction at 2 and 4 position. Similarly, in case of quinoline also undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction, because It acts as a pyridine ring. In your isoquinoline, it is fused between pyridine and benzene ring. So your pyridine, quinoline also undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction at second position. It also undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction at the second position. Okay. Next, first is you treat it with sodamide and liquid nitrogen, it forms 2-aminoquinoline. The same thing, if when you treat quinoline with KOH at high temperature, it forms 2-hydroxyquinoline. And the same reaction, when you treat with it butyl lithium, it forms 2-N-butylquinoline. So these are the nucleophilic reactions of quinoline. You have to write this thing because this comes as full question, right? Write the reactions and synthesis of quinoline and isoquinoline together. So you have to write for 10 marks. So it can come for 10 marks also. Write the reactions and synthesis of your quinoline and isoquinoline. So you have to write the reactions also. So I'll go for the next slide. So if you see, all the reactions are almost the same. All the reactions are almost the same. So nucleophilic addition takes place at the second and the fourth. Basically, if the second position is blocked, then only it takes place at the fourth. Basically, the preferred position is the second one. Okay. I'll go for the next slide. So all the things you see, only thing is that you have to put OH, NH2 and butyl group at the second position. Now, electrophilic substitution reaction. Electrophilic substitution reaction. So the nitrogen, both quinoline and isoquinoline contains a pyridine ring and a fused, which is fused to your benzene ring. Yes, you can see. It contains both pyridine and a benzene ring. And see the numbering. Can you see the numbering? Quinoline, in quinoline, it is given, one is given to your nitrogen. Whereas in case of isoquinoline, it is an isoform. So nitrogen is getting the second numbering, which is against your constant nomenclature. So when you write isoform, so there is a shift in the position. So that's why in case of isoquinoline, nitrogen gets the second position. Whereas in case of quinoline, plain quinoline, nitrogen gets the first position. Okay. So nitrogen containing rings behave as a pyridine and the other ring behaves as a naphthalene mark. So that is a fused benzene ring. What is naphthalene? Two fused benzene rings. So the pyridine part of your quinoline reacts, behaves as an pyridine. And the other ring, that is benzene containing part of your quinoline, acts as an naphthalene. So according to that, it undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction mostly